Hello friends, today we will be discussing communication technology for smart grid. Now in past two videos we have already seen many other communication protocols which is being used. In this particular presentation we will be discussing about the ZigBee. Now from where the name has come, the ZigBee. First of all we should understand that this name is referred to a waggle dance by the honeybee, which they return to their beehives, which means the honeybees always return to their home following a zigzag path. Even if they follow n number of zigzag paths, but that is one thing is for sure, that they return to their home safely. And that particular information is being transferred to other bees and they also follow the same path. So basically what ZigBee protocol means is, in case of any path, communication is being getting completed, whether it's a path number 1 or path number 2 or path number 3 or 4 or any other path. So that is the important thing of ZigBee, which means the path has been completed through any means, somehow the communication has to take place and communication has to be successful. So this was the very basic of ZigBee and how the name has come. So the name has come from the waggle dance of the honeybee. So we have seen it's a high level communication protocol which is being used for personal area network, which is a small area, which with obviously if you're talking about a small area it will be a low power digital signal radios. And since we are talking about the low power signals and a small area, so it is widely used for home automation or some medical data device data collections or any other low power low bandwidth needs. So basically this protocol is being used for a small scale project which needs a wireless connection. So ZigBee protocol is based on IEEE standards 802.15.4. So we can see here, since we are talking about a very low power and a small area, so basically this particular protocol is a low data rate, has low power, and it has to be in close proximity. So basically we can say that wireless is a very personal area network and which is connecting device to device network. Next, if you talk about the indoor, the wireless range, ZigBee offers a 70 meters and 400 meters for the outdoor range. The ZigBee can transmit data over a long distance, but that is only possible if you have intermediate devices which will create a mesh network to reach a long distance. The ZigBee has a defined rate of 250 kbits per second and it has a specific single frequency of 2.4 GHz. Moving ahead, features of ZigBee. ZigBee has a typically integrated the radio and the microcontrollers, which has a memory, flash memory of let's say 60 to 256 kV. Then it started in 1998, it was standardized in 2003 and it was revised in 2006. So from these features we can very easily understand that ZigBee is very easily to integrate monitoring and control of the light systems, let's say security systems, convenience and motion detection. So the first and the foremost thing is the sending and receiving data. Now in any wireless network, for any data sending activity or receiving activity, there should be a node between the network, which makes the things easy. The wireless networking, the reliable data transfer is very easy with the help of the nodes. Now the ZigBee is a methodology, is a protocol where the route will be automatically figured out and the data from one node to another will be transferred with a maximum chance of success. So this is the benefit of ZigBee protocol. Now the ZigBee uses some standard networking terms. Those networking terms are nothing but the data request, data confirmation and the data indication, which means the transmit data and then acknowledgement of the data request and we have an acknowledgement of the data received. So the ZigBee network topology is basically star, mesh and cluster tree. So these are the topologies in which the ZigBee devices will be connected. Now let's try to understand its working, how a ZigBee protocol works. You can see here, for any ZigBee network to proper function, it should have a coordinator for sure. The coordinator is the most important device into the entire network, which will coordinate everything. The coordinator will have the addresses of all the routers and the details of all the devices connected into the system. So the coordinator is basically the important device which will try to coordinate the routing of the data from the device to the routers or the from one device to another device. So this is how a ZigBee protocol works. You can see here there are three routers and there are some end devices which are being connected through a coordinator. Now seeing this, there are applications, various applications, as we have already discussed, it's used for low power and small area. So applications will be wireless light switching in home, energy monitors and traffic management systems and other consumers and industrial equipments that requires very short range and low rate wireless data transfer. There are many applications which is depicted in the next slide. Let's see here, for example, if you're talking about building automation, then it is security system, area, light control, access control. Similarly, for energy management, then consumer electronics, then PC and peripherals, home controls, telecom services, healthcare services, and industry controls. So these many areas can be covered with ZigBee protocol. So overall, ZigBee is what it is, a protocol which is used for communication, which is used for a low range, for low power, and a small area it is covering. So I hope you would have understood the ZigBee protocol. Thank you very much.